Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this channel. As you all know that we are in quarantine. If the invisible virus can scare you, then the invisible God can or has also the power to save you. Today I have come up with a very different topic, how to utilize kids' free time, which is not related to any book. You know children, due to the deadly disease called coronavirus, which is an infectious disease caused by a new virus, all schools and colleges are closed, due to which all kids are locked up inside the room. They must be getting bored, isn't it? Because neither they can go anywhere nor play with anyone. They cannot visit any mall, friends, as a result of which not only the kids but their parents too are getting bored and does not know what to do. It is not only these holidays which they have got, also during other holidays also you can utilize these tips on your kids. As a teacher, I receive many complaints like, ma'am, my child annoys us a lot, does not listen to us or watches TV the whole day long. So in order to overcome these problems, I am stating few tips which may help you to keep your child busy and do some productive work in a very creative manner. Do watch my video till end, as many interesting tips are given for keeping your child busy. How to boost up your child's brain by playful method? I am going to discuss all these topics also. So let us see what are those points which will boost up your child's activity. My first point is extracurricular activities. You know dear children and parents, the quality of life is determined by its activities. So, in this extracurricular activities, we can include activities like drawing, painting, singing, dancing, instrument playing, etc. You can enhance their activities during holidays or free time. You can motivate your child so that they can polish their qualities in the above activities. You can also create interest in them by these activities. You can collect these information from Google or YouTube. You involve your child daily for an hour or 1.5 hours, not more than this, so that they can develop their skills and shine in that field. For that, you have to motivate them without wasting time. For this, every parent should fix a proper time for them. Like for example, painting can be done in various ways. They can see from some books and draw and paint accordingly. You, that is the parents, should motivate them and appreciate them for their work. Next is playing instruments. Music is a fantastic peacekeeper of the world. It is integral to harmony and it is a required fundamental or human emotions. They can learn by seeing the notes from the Google and enhance their skill and practice whatever they had learned before. Next is singing. Singing, you know children, it exercises your hearts, lungs and releases endorphins, making you feel good. Music speaks what cannot be expressed, soothes the mind and gives its rest, heals the heart and makes it whole flows from heaven to the soul. So motivate your child to sing. As you know, life is a song, sing it. Next is dancing. Dance is a joy of moment and the heart of life. Everybody can dance. It's the drive and passion. that makes you a dancer. Dance is a conversation between body and soul. You know, children, when I was young like you, I was very fond of this quote, which I am telling you. We dance for laughter, we dance for tears, we dance for madness, we dance for fears, we dance for hopes, we dance for screams. We are the dancers, we create the dreams, so you must dance to your tune. My second point is gardening. Encourage your child for gardening, in which you can give them basic ideas, for example, how to plant, how to sow the seeds. Certainly they will be motivated and interested in this activity. Also teach them how to grow plants, which plant is suitable for which season, how to water them or spray water on them, on these plants, take care of the plants. All these kinds of activity will really delight them and make them responsible. Garden is a friend you can always visit anytime. My third point is inculcate the habit of reading. Now, every child will not perform or is interested in singing, dancing, gardening, etc. Or they can not perform these work for the whole day. They can go for those activities in which your child is interested. Like, you can purchase some books online, e-books, and books which are already with them. Tell them to mark some important points and note them in their diary, which will prove beneficial for them. And it is a noted fact that the children are very much interested to do those work which are of their interest. This will divert their mind as well as will perform and will prove helpful to them in their study. This is also one of the way to make your child busy, but do remember that do not leave them alone. You also involve yourself with them. You go through the points, whatever your child has written, this will prove beneficial for the child and he will be more interested in reading the books. Marking important points, etc., and do encourage them, then they will be more interested in doing that particular activity. My fourth point is improvement of handwriting. Handwriting determines your dream. How beautiful your dream is, so is your handwriting. So you can improve your handwriting sections during these holidays. Whether it is English or Hindi, or you can develop their skills regarding other languages and tell them or motivate them to learn some other language also. These days, you can get everything in Google or in YouTube. These languages chosen by them, tell them to learn few words every day so that they have a knowledge of a new language. Don't burden them with lots of words, otherwise they will not be able to remember them. You can tell them that your child can write 5 words in their notebook and practice them. In this way, your child will learn a new language and will be a plus point for them. My fifth point is playway method. You can also teach them and teach your child by playway method. So what are those games in which your memory is boosted and your involvement of brain will be there so that you can concentrate properly? So what are those games which are very simple? And if I say that, there are some of the games which are old and they are still played till today. But today's children are more interested in video games and mobile games. If you teach your child by playing method, then definitely they will be able to absorb properly. So whatever what are those games, and whatever they learn, they will never forget. The first and the most games which are played by many children even today, especially the girls, is teacher. In this game, you can give the child a blackboard and the parents should become a child. And when your child is playing the role of a teacher, tell him or her to explain. You learn from your child and cross-question them. This will develop their confidence in the child to stand and speak freely without getting nervous. Another game is Ghar Ghar, which you can play with your child. In this game, you knock the door, the child will open. Teach them how to greet the guest or a teacher or a mother or a father, whatever role you are playing with your child. Respond to them, call them, wish them by telling Namaste. Ask them to sit, offer them a glass of water. All these things and converse with them are very important, as it teaches them the etiquettes of life and also being social. This game will help them to excel. Being a teacher, I come across many students who does not talk in the class. They have hardly one or two friends. But when I meet their parents, then they say that the child is very naughty at home and is very talkative. This kind of playway method will teach your child who are introvert to build confidence in them, to converse in the group, will not feel hesitated, and this game of Ghar Ghar will be a good practice for your child to build the confidence level within themselves. If your child is shy, do try this method. It will definitely be helpful for you. These are really helpful, very helpful method. Apart from playing with your child, you are also teaching them very innovative things and many more things. Another game is marking a word in a paragraph in 1 second. Then tell your child to recheck if the words is left out. In this game, the word can lie anywhere. You have to keep this point in mind. It may be in the middle or at the start or in the end. Like for example, if I take this paragraph, the coronavirus is a large family of viruses that causes illness ranging from the common cold to acute respiratory syndromes. Now if I say to mark A, then the child can mark all alphabets A in this paragraph. Whether it is A is lying at the start or middle or in the end. You have to teach your child to read full paragraph carefully and read each word properly so that the alphabet is marked. This increases the concentration power of a child and will do well in academics. So you have seen how interesting is this game, and along with it increases the level and power of concentration in your child, and the child learns to concentrate. Apart from this, there are some other things which you can make your child do, or you can make a timetable for them to perform those work from morning till night. There are some things which are very general. These days, as all members are there in the house, so there is a lot of work also to be performed. You can take the help of your children. You can tell them to clean their rooms, and you will observe that when a child cleans the room, then they will not make it dirty very soon, as it is the result of their hard work. But if the room is cleaned by mother, then it only takes few seconds to make them dirty. Tell your child to clean their room, organize all the materials of the room in the proper place. You will see that Within 1 or 2 days, the child will either not be interested or be very interested, and slowly he will develop this habit, and you don't have to lose hope, but be after him with patience. Suppose there is no separate room in your house for your child, then you can include him in some other work. You can make him or her responsible for those work and delegate him or her with those responsibilities by telling them that they have to perform that work every day. These small learnings will boost their confidence as well as make them responsible. This is a time when you should put in and involve yourself with the child. This also helps in increasing the bonding with them. Otherwise, during holidays, where do we stay at home? We all go to another place to refresh our minds, either to some religious or on some adventurous trip. If you think your child is growing up, then you can also teach some cooking skills. Suppose your child is not very big, don't take them near the gas. But other small things, like if you teach your child, he or she will learn very fast. As you know, learning is a continuous process. The more you teach a child, the better he or she will be. Don't leave your child idle. Always make them busy with some activities. Cooking is also a good way of learning, as it increases concentration, interest, and it also develops the taste of making the food. Make the child learn, first of all his favorite dishes. This he or she will do it very nicely, as he will be interested or she will be interested in it. Children eat very less, so if you involve your child in the kitchen, then I think he or she will start eating a little more, and they have made it. These tricks should be applied by all mothers, and I know they do apply in their own way. Even I did that. Now lastly, what I have to give you the tips is that teach your child to serve food on the dining table. Teach them where to keep water, where to keep spoons, sponge the plates and keep on the table before serving the food. Involve them so that they learn it, whether you are living in a nuclear family or in a joint family. In this way, they will be learning many little things and will not be involved only in watching the television. So you can surely do these small things to help your child grow during vacations. How did you like this video and the tips suggested by me? If you are new to my video, then do subscribe my channel. I hope these tips will be helpful for your child to learn and grow. With these notes, I end today's video. Stay strong, stay positive, stay healthy, stay at home. Thank you.